The edit and mix groups are a powerful tool that allow multiple tracks to be adjusted or edited as if they were a single unit. A good example of this are my 12 tracks of drums just here. They represent the 12 microphones placed around the drums. Now in the edit window, you can see each corresponding region representing each element of the drum kit. Now once all 12 tracks have been balanced for listening and edit purposes, I'm going to want to move all of these 12 faders together as one, while maintaining their relative volume levels. But just as important as the levels are the regions in the edit window. These cannot really be moved or edited as single events. This would create all types of phase and timing problems between your different drum tracks. Edit group solves this problem. A drum edit group would also allow alternate playlists with different takes to be changed across the entire drum kit. And you definitely want that. Really critical if you're comping a final drum performance from one, two, or more takes. Now by default, there is an all edit group in the lower left corner. Now turning this on will let you edit across every single track in the session. In this session, that's all of the drums, the two bass tracks, and my master fader track. Now the all edit group is also a mix group, allowing for all of the fader levels to be trimmed together while maintaining their individual volume levels, regardless of which fader you move. Now technically, the all group is referred to as a mix edit group. That's why it appears in both the mix window and the edit window. To turn the all groups off, just deselect it in the groups pane. Now to create a group that is specific to the drums in our session, choose group from the track menu and the create group dialog is going to open up. Now in the top left, you can name the group and select the type of group that you want. An edit, mix, or a mix edit group. Now I'm going to select my drum tracks from the list on the left-hand side and add them to the right-hand side. Nice. The ID for this group is going to be A. Now as far as the parameters that this group will control, that's done with the attributes tab. For this group, I only want to control volume. You can also tell the group to follow global, in which case the attributes will gray out and the group will follow the global attributes. Turn follow global off and we're back to what we had before. Hit enter to close the window. Now you can see our drum group in the edit window, off and then back on. Now edits can be made across all 12 drum tracks. That's selecting and deleting, trimming, and even applying fades and crossfades, or the editing done without compromising the relationship between the individual regions. Now the drum group allows us to select an alternate playlist on any one of the individual drum tracks and have that change be applied across all 12 drum tracks. Very, very useful when comping gets underway. Now because we made this group a mix edit group, it's available in the mix window. Check it out. The 12 faders all move together. You can turn the group off with the lettered ID. In this case, it's A, and then toggle it back on. Nice. Now when a group's enabled, each track will indicate the group it belongs to directly above the pan control. Clicking here lets you see which tracks belong to that group, as well as modify the group. And you can also duplicate, delete, and even select all of the tracks belonging to that group. That's nice. Okay, so let's deactivate group A and let's make some more groups. I'm going to work with my overheads. I'm going to bring down both bass channels. I'm going to select both the overhead tracks before opening the Create Groups dialog using Command G or Control G on Windows. Now I'm going to make it a mix-only group. Same attributes as before, and you can see it gets the next ID, which is B. Now that's the overheads done, let's bring up the faders and begin playback. Let's bring up kick 2, kick 1, shift select both tracks, and then Command or Control G. Name it. Make it a mix only, and hit OK. do the snares. Gonna bring up snare two. Up with snare one, that's got a bit more wood in it. The bottom snare drum. And again, let's select all of the tracks that we want within this group and then press Command or Control G to open up the Create Groups dialog. Make it a mix only, name it, and hit OK. So now our snare drums move together as a group, Group D, and there are the kick drums on Group C. Now with the toms, I'm going to make a slight change to the attributes. I'm going to make it a mix only, name it toms, but this time I want volume, mute, and solo. Now the faders are grouped together, and the group indicator above the pan reflects the E group, which is toms. Pressing E on your keyboard will turn the group off and allow for individual control, and then press E again to activate the tom group. Another way to temporarily defeat a group is to clutch out a fader while holding down the control key, and that's the Windows key on the PC. Let go of the modifier and the group is restored. Now, because the tom group has different attributes, we can mute the three tom tracks together. We can solo them together as well. Nice. I'm just going to bring up the hi-hat track. This track doesn't have any ride cymbals, so I can leave that level at zero. Now, just like with the very first drum group that we made, the bass needs to be a mix edit group. Two bass signals were recorded in the session, a tube DI track, and one recorded using a Sansamp bass effect. So I'm going to select both the bass tracks, Command or Control G to open the Create Groups window, and I'm going to leave it as a mix edit, that is the default, and I'm going to call it bass, and then I'm going to deselect the mute and the solo attributes. So now the faders are grouped together, but I still have individual control over the solo and the mute options. Nice. In the edit window, you can see the bass tracks highlighting together when I make a selection or an edit. So the last thing I want to do is visit the original drum group that we created at the top of this movie. So now that my drums are roughly balanced, I want group A turned back on, allowing me to trim down or even off, and then back up again, all while retaining the relative values between the individual drum tracks. So now what I'm going to do is create and assign what we call a VCA master fader or a voltage control amplifier fader to my drum tracks. And we do this from the track menu, just create new, the same way you would any other track, but we're going to make a stereo VCA master fader. And to assign a VCA master to a group, just click here and choose one of the groups. With the VCA master now assigned, I need only move that fader to trim down all the relative levels of the faders within my drum kit. Now VCA masters are nice because once they're assigned to a group, only the VCA can move the faders together relative to each other. And this leaves the individual drum channels to react to the other mix groups that we created. There's the paired overhead mics and the three snare drum channels. And this is both powerful and flexible for when you begin mixing or your editing session. To trim all 12 drum channels at once, just reach over and grab the VCA master fader.